Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.
Without me doing that. Okay, yes! End of the week is here. Nyege Nyege is upon us. We are so pumped, we are so psyched, and I am not showing up. In other news though, this episode was proudly sponsored by none other than Nana Habo Mouthwash. Get the product, try the product. Let's delve into what's been happening in the world of gossip since Monday to today and all the things Nebi Gendeda Kwa around this day. I'm Tina Fierce One. Welcome. Oh, where should I start from? I got word, I got wind of apparently Stacia Mayanja has left Golden Band. I was like, what? Not that we care. Who listens to their music? Aba fumbo. Gwetolimo fumbo. Ngato mungulitisa. Hey, there's a difference. Music was Stacia and Golden Band. Aba mungulitisa aba fumbo. For him, he's married. So there's a difference between aba fumbo and married. Tata Gwasinga, Sigena na Biongereza ako. Anywho, she's left Golden Band and she say, apart from what the stories that we're hearing, the whole thing came down when she bought someone else's concert, thinking it was going to make her some little money. Nagendo tu, kayonga waliyo ba upcoming artist, sino butebenga bunji. Kakati that broke her back and her bank. She's like, I cannot do this anymore. So I'm asking myself, bani yabali mo Golden Band? Ronald Mayinja. Mayinja liku joining a politics, right? Misach Semakula. Misach built a huge studio. It's making a lot of money for him. He doesn't have time to be a part of the band. Who else? Atapana Misach bana to see manyo byokola bana Misach ayize omulimo gwenna kuzino. Owafira omuyimbi we at the moment an artist dies. Bana Misach ya so cow. It's such a beautiful thing though. I don't know how he gets notified that fast though. Emizimo jikubira ye. So I'm looking at the entire lineup of the people that made up Golden Band and have left and are doing their own thing. And in my mind, I'm like, you know what? This serves all of you right. Because you wanted to hold on too long to the spotlight. Golden Band, I've had some of them singing. And they are exquisite. Their breath of fresh air. That is the same problem we have with the entire music industry. Someone they want to mentor them to a certain degree and they do not want them to stop. Like to where you get out. Anyway, I don't care about the Golden Band. I don't listen to their music. Chiria chiringange omufali sogobasi ba muchiimba mu bandage. Obuyimba bwokutu soya soya tubukoye. Hey, pimya ka number. Nyo. People are looking at you like, look at this one. We are in the 21st century. We are trying to fight for equal rights and dampe uchaliku. Mfunye ka number. Loli loli. And of course, for all of you who know what time it is, get yourself a copy of The Kampala Sun is Poppin'. Let's take a quick look at what, repping Kampala Hangouts. Corporate chick cornered in Ntinda. But I live in Ntinda. How come I don't know this Kabala? Ah! Chidi Kampala. Anyway, she says she survived rep at a particular bar. Ladies, you finna go out there holding shit. Like, you need to start moving muli prepared, pepper spray, razor blades. I love to randomly throw razor blades in my handbag. It's a good feeling. So every time I dip my finger in, I know who I'm going to cut. Bossi kafuse bossi kwa mukama katonda. Woo! He's a father of two, he's a carpenter, and he has stolen our hearts. He has stolen our hearts. Quick look at what's happening. Nyege nyege. Nyege nyege is an expression of cultural diversity. No, that is not what Lokodo sings. Prophet Elvis Mbonye, has 9 Range Rovers. They're 9. In white. That is with the exception of the other fancy cars he owns. And his followers are like, ooh-wee, ooh-wee, go daddy, we finna worship you. Where do you think the money that bought all those Range Rovers comes from? And the guys at Zambonye Ngazirina sent. And the guys at Zambonye Ngazirina sent. 9 Range Rovers! Mwe taito wamwe baba gamba mwe yomeka. Mtu wala ya chumu kwa chukumi, really? Owe chukumi chwa kumi cha is what? 30 million per person? Huh? How did he convince a bunch of people with their kids to walk into a church, lock it up, pour petrol on themselves and set themselves ablaze. How did he do that? What kind of brainwashing was that? What? How did he talk to them to go and sell off all their property because it's going to be Y2K at some point? And he convinced all of them to die? Now this is why, whenever I ask myself those questions, is when I understand, do not underestimate the power of someone who makes you believe in a greater being than you. You have to be very cautious with these people because they have mastered the beautiful art of convincing you it's for the higher being, for the higher purpose, for a higher everything. Anyway, I've got 9 French Rovers. Anyway, I cannot say anything derogatory about anybody's religion because that's what you decide to believe in. We all need something to believe in at the end of the day, but I'm just saying 9 Range Rovers. I mean, my Catholic priest takes 2 beers and I'm wondering which of us paid for that beer. But 9? Ooh, child. Not that I'm exempting our Catholic priests, but 9? According to the Kampala Sun, this is what they had to say. The tithe game, because there's a celebrity death match between Prophet Elvis Mbonye and Apostle Grace. First of all, ani aba wazi no tithe wazi. How does it happen? Do they take some classes in theology? Do they try to understand life and, you know, switch it up and mix it up, shake it properly with regular life and Jesus' life? I don't know. But one is a prophet, the other is an apostle. So I guess we have apostolic prophets in the building. So according to the Kampala Sun, here's what they're saying. At Zoe Fellowship, tithing is very important. Yes, have you met those 9 Range Rovers? It's Finnaby. Finnaby! So he says, so much that that every seat is given an envelope to tithe. And another that has a special prophecy.
I'm sorry.
Wait, you have to, there are two envelopes, right? So one is for the tithe, which is good. Everybody needs to tithe. And then they give you another envelope. Now that other envelope is for the prophecy. Wait, like our prophecies are lined up like candy bars. Go pick one. Anywho. Like all these churches, like the entire sermon, just goes around one thing. Tithe, sow the seed. But now give us sowing our seeds in born again churches. It's a beautiful thing, you know? Because you have you reap what you sow. Like I said, I will not be derogatory towards anybody's religious affiliation. Do you, but I'm just saying 9 went wrong. Bambi Rabadaba, I'm here reading about him, but he went, there's that campus night at Club Amnesia, right? Like most musicians always do the video premieres from there. So Rabba came and he dropped some of his new music and the crowd was like, Poor man had to end up just getting the one song that everyone loves. Yo bode, mkalakata yo bode, Bambi. Nana kuna yeye aloga bana za rabada bando za baku yole ligere. Rabba, wetaga Mbonye, wetaga Poso, wetaga Prophet, wetaga Lusozi, wetaga Mukama. Gendo buze church atwala yo stardom kubanga is really, really, really bad, son. My name is Atina Fierce One on Twitter. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and Atina Fierce One. Don't forget to like and follow the pages. On Instagram, it's Atina Fierce One with an H. Don't forget, don't drink and drive. Get yourself a designated driver. Or, I actually just saw that Uber brought for us choppers. I was like, my word. You mean I can take a flight from here to Kisasi? So what? Like, I need to upgrade my Uber thingy or something. Sitegera. But I saw flights are going to Jinja. Baku jako meka. Basa sulanga betu sasule motoka. Estimate, yes. Yes. Boy, you are joking. Anywho, it's been my time. Catch you again all on Monday. I hope it's a good week. I do hope it's a good week. Don't forget, always wear protection, whether it's here or there, wherever. You know, wear your protection. Don't drink and drive. Get your designated driver. I'm out. Peace.
Scoop and Scoop.
Scoop was sponsored by
Get Nana Herbal Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.